Rojak. I love the rojak. I love that.
Yeah.
I love it because it's texture. It's crunchy, crispy, sweet, sour, salty. It's all those things all in one. That's yummy.
That's yummy. And of course, you also tried some dishes that the fans voted for you to try.
Yes.
Malaysian dishes. What we did was on Lifetime in the past month, past few weeks actually, we asked the viewers of Lifetime to submit what they think George should try to eat while he's here in Malaysia. And so they came up with the top three, and the top three was asam laksa, nasi kerabu, and ochien, otherwise known as oyster omelette. And yeah, you had fun, didn't you?
I like the oyster omelette, that was my favorite. Ooh, that is heavy, isn't it? It's very funky.
Yeah. And why the taste, you said?
Well, you know what? If I could just, you know, when you've got a really bad flu, that gets rid of everything.
I feel like you're scared. I swear. Yeah. You could. Just like a good tom yum as well.
That's right.
Okay. Well, it's been 6 seasons of MasterChef Australia. Mm. So what is it about the show that makes you, you know, that still excites you?
Well, technically, yes, 6 main plus 2 kids. Celebrity, professionals, so yeah, it feels like a lifetime full of TV. Over 500 episodes of TV. And Matt Preston's our statistician, he keeps the stats on how many hours we've worked. But I had no idea what I was getting myself into. I'm a cook and a chef that has dedicated my lifetime to stovetop, and I love that dealing. And I'm still connected to that immensely, but of course now my life is made up of lots of different parts, and MasterChef has been this this amazing roller coaster for me, where it's been able to give me so much, and I respect that. We put a lot of hard work into it. I think there's a reason why it airs in over 100 odd countries, and including right here. I'm privileged, I'm honoured, I respect the fact that it's a show. Antonio Carluccio said to me last year when we were shooting together, a recipe got our food team put a recipe together, and they made a mistake, and it was a secret bus, and they put add parmesan at the end, and it's a big no-no, we know that. They made a mistake, and Antonio looked at me and he goes, you know, you have the responsibility, a big responsibility, because the last thing we need is the world to know that you put parmesan on seafood pasta. And he's right, you know, he's right. The three of us have got a massive responsibility. We take our jobs really seriously, not only because our names are on the door, and we have to make sure that the right contestants are on the show, that have the right attitude, the right humility, and the right ambitions. Yeah.
Of course, we've got